Hey guys, if you receive that error code, you might be in big trouble. And maybe today is your lucky day if you watch that video until the end. That error code cannot be deleted unless you do the procedure which I will show you now. And in the special function on my launch, you have to find DME CAS adjustment procedure and you need to execute it, and I will show you how. One advice, guys, always read your description before executing any procedure on your launch, and I will read it for you quickly. The car access system serves as an anti-theft alarm system and enables the start of the BMW. A transponder chip is integrated in each of the vehicle keys. A ring coil is fitted above the ignition lock. The transponder chip is powered by this coil from the car access system. This means that no battery is necessary in the key. The power supply and the data transfer take place in the same way as a transformer between the loop coil at the ignition lock and the transponder chip. The key then sends data to the car access system. If these data are correct, the CAS control unit enables the starter by means of a relay located in the control unit and additionally sends a coded start enable signal via data link to the engine control unit. The engine cannot be started before the signal has been transferred. The ECU only enables engine start if a correct enable signal is received from the CAS unit. Identical random codes are stored in the CAS unit and in the engine control unit. The value of these codes changes after every start procedure. Start enable only takes place if the code sent by the CAS unit agrees with the code calculated in the ECU. The control units are allocated only during initial programming of the ECU. The engine control unit then adopts the basic code of the CAS control unit. The following procedure takes place after inserting the vehicle key in the ignition lock. The transponder in the key is powered via the loop coil and sends the key data to the CAS control unit. The CAS unit checks the key data to ensure if it's correct and only then sends the enable signal to the starter. The CAS unit sends the random code to the ECU. There, the random code is checked against the saved variable code. If they match, the fuel injection system is released. Okay guys, matching procedure completed and the engine start is possible now. Let's try it out. And yes, it's alive again. So I hope you appreciate the video. If you do, please like it and subscribe for the channel for more.